Hello YouTube land, it is me, Justin King, again with another video. This time I was tagged in a goth tag, and I usually don't do these, but this one is more focused on the music, and I'm all about spreading that. So if you are watching me for the first time because of this tag, hi there! As I mentioned, I am Justin King and this is my channel. My focus of the channel is I'm obviously a black person and I'm a goth. So I mostly talk about what it's like to be black in the goth community. I do things such as share music called the Music Earworm series, where I do episodes showcasing goth music of bands or individual artists that are hugely underrepresented, in my opinion, on social media. I also have a series called Unsung Black Goth Heroes, where I showcase the goths that are black, that are musicians from back in the day bands to current, that have provided music for us. I also do another series called We Buy Black, where it's not officially goth, but I show you the haul of everything black, be it from food to clothing to makeup to household cleaning items and more that I have bought with my own hard-earned cash, and I want to showcase those brands to spread more awareness about ways that you can buy black. I also have a few other series, such as Music That Gets Me Through, where I get to share music that really connects to me on an emotional level that isn't a part of the goth series. So there's a little bit something that is unique for many different people out there. And I was tagged by the house of, y'all who know me know that I don't pronounce words that well. Let's see if I can try. House of Wyvern, specifically, let's see, Finnig, maybe, if I pronounce that right, and Queen of Dragons. So both of them created the topic called the Project Goth Playlist Tag, the ongoing music sharing collaboration of goth creators. And this was the house's effort to put more music onto the YouTube channel and sharing of bands instead of the focus of fashion.
Hello and welcome back to another House of Wyvern video. Today's video is going to be a little bit different because we're going to be launching a tag. Now, this tag came about through the Gothy Discord. The idea is essentially to spread, educate, quell some misinformation that's been going online lately, well, since forever. But the idea is to put out some form of recommendation for a goth band that's true to the genre, which has to fit within genres of goth, which I will put up now.
The band that I decided to do is showcasing what I previously just said that I do, bringing out bands that have black artists in there that are not talked about a lot. This is a band called Big Audio Dynamite. And the first bit of the tag says, suggest a brand, which I just did. How did I find Big Audio Dynamite? Well, I found it how I'm finding most of my music nowadays, which nowadays means probably the past 8 or 9 years, which is music streaming services. The current one that I'm on is Google Music for free, but you name it, I've probably gone through all the free sessions. And I find that for me, for the free sessions, Google has enough variety of goth music, so if you pick a band, no matter what, you're probably not going to hear the same 3 songs in repetition over and over again, which unfortunately happens with other streaming services. So the next bit is a little bit of what I usually do with these types of videos, talking about the band's history, some albums, additional information, or anything of that nature. So I'm assuming a lot of y'all don't know what Big Audio Dynamite is, because they are not ones that are talked about often on social media, at least from what I've glanced upon and the things that I've seen shared around that I've watched or others have commented on. So they, according to Wikipedia, are a part of the post-punk / alternative dance band. They started in London, England, hometown. They have been active from 1984 to 1997, and then they had a splurge again where they decided to reemerge in 2011. It says a little bit more about them on Wikipedia that they were formed by Mick Jones, who is the former lead guitarist of The Clash. The band is noted for its effective mixture of varied musical styles, incorporating elements of punk rock, dance music, hip-hop, reggae, and funk. Big Audio Dynamite's one constant throughout frequent shifts in membership and musical direction is the vocals provided by Mick Jones. I want to take the time to quickly bring up the black musicians that I found in the group. But the first one I wanted to discuss, who is the black musician in the group, is Don Leitz. And Don Leitz is a British film director, DJ, and musician. He first came to prominence by being the videographer for The Clash and directed several of their music videos. It says that him and Mick Jones co-founded Big Audio Dynamite, and he also did music videos for other bands such as the Psychedelic Furs. Once again, Psychedelic Furs is down with the black people. If you're part of my regular viewership, you know that I have mentioned a lot of black artists in the goth scene, as in specifically post-punk, that have been working with them. So no surprise there. He also worked with the Pretenders as well. And he also directed feature documentaries, The Punk Rock Movie in 1977, and The Clash, West Way to the World, which was in 2000. He also did a book called Culture Clash, Dread Meets Punk Rockers, which might be something I look into. The next person who is black and a part of the group that I wanted to mention is Leo Williams. He's also known as Easy Kill, and he is a bass guitarist. Joined them and the original in 1984. And then finally, as of right now, if I don't add another one in, the next person that is in this group is Ranking Roger, who is formerly known as Roger Charlie. And he is a vocalist, also a part of the punk rock and new wave scene too. So that's pretty darn cool. I also want to mention that he was also a part of post-punk new wave band The Beat, which is pretty damn cool. So he is someone very situated into this genre. From there, we're going to go to the next segment of the tag, which is the suggested tracks. Usually I like to keep tracks down to 2 at the max. I usually only do 3 or 4 if I'm feeling extra, because I like to give a little sample of the song with the video so you can vibe with it. So we're going to pick a few of the songs. The first song I'm going to showcase to y'all is V13 off of their album Planet Bag Greatest Hits. This is a very Love and Rockets vibe, which, if you don't know, Love and Rockets is a offshoot band that came after Bauhaus. So they're also like Jesus and the Mary Chain, which I think is also very similar to that vibe of goth music, which I think of as kind of like a dark flower child vibe. That's how I view it. So again, like I mentioned, Big Audio Dynamite is post-punk. They combine DJ, so that is a combination of sampling, which, I mean, other genres of goth do that too a lot. So Let's get into a little sample of V13.
Good morning, Sodom and Gomorrah. Good morning, sinners. No, that wasn't your radio sets on the blink again.
Again, V13, that's one side of them, and from there I want to go to another song of theirs called E equals MC Square.
Somebody I never met, but in a way I know, didn't think that you could get so much from a picture show, man dies first, real people ask what's the deal, this ain't how it's supposed to be, don't like no aborigine, took a trip in Power Square. Shouting monsters came and flushing out. Gangland's laying on the ground. New identity must be found. On the left hand for a while. Insanity, bohemian style. Blend your life.
Scratch my head and wonder why time slides into time across the national dateline. Scientists eat bubblegum, Hall of Fame, baseball, senators a hoodlum, big chiefs in a hall.
This is off their album, this is Big Audio Dynamite. And it definitely showcases, at least on the image of the album cover that I can see on YouTube, is the whole gothic cowboy vibe, which is a thing, especially down here in the South. So that's pretty cool. That was my part of the tag, the Big Audio Dynamite band. Put it in the comment section below. Have you heard of this band before? Do you think that they are unknown or way too popular and I was just off with my perception? If you have heard of them before, what are some of the songs that you like from them or some of your favorite albums? Thanks again to the House of... Wyvern? Sorry. But thank you so much again, House, for including me as part of the initial tag. And if you guys weren't a part of the initial tag, I challenge you guys to fill this out. In fact, I'll mention a few people that I know that aren't a part of this original tag that you can do. Everyone can, but these are people that I interact with a lot that are part of the whole gothic group. I'm gonna tag.
As I remember, and if you aren't on here, it's not that you aren't included in the tag. It's simply that I couldn't find you or I don't know of you. But everyone is free to do so. I spent the time to look into pretty much anyone that I've connected with so far, be it subscribers or people that I subscribe to or people that I've commented back and forth with a little bit. So it's going to be a list. Grab the popcorn. Starting off the tag, we have Angel Nightmare, who I think already got tagged, but just in case you didn't, here you go. Audrey Revenge, Dark Harmony, Deadly Pixie, Eternal Winter, Disasterina, Filet de Porcelain, Glam Goth, Goth on a Budget, I Am George, Lisa Laduquerre, Marisa Nadler, Moi Dark Moss, Fiora Nix, Raven Poe 1849, Ravens and Roses, Rose Nocturnalia, Scarfing Scarves, Sean James, This is Raven, Vander Von Odd, Victoria Fashion, Victoria P. Who's That Girl? Which, in my opinion, a lot of y'all are sleeping on. If you like people that take the time to create looks from thrifting, from just doing like online shopping on the non-official goth websites and really taking the time to put their look and makeup together and referencing different eras of goth in the past, please, please, please do them. Sky ID, Blazing Orchids, Gothic Homemaker, Queenie Todd, The Graveyard Baby, M. Wren, Argold Dinosaur, Keita Darkwolf, Inna Black, Jonah Kalari, Vanessa Little, Little Mortician, Mary Munsterful, Oanimus M40, Britton Kingsley, The Asexual Goddess, Dark Alternative, Andrea Martz, Audido Discourse, Gothic and Goth, Dark Fairy 1981, Very Unusual, and your wife as well. The last I saw, she was going by Iridescent Veins, but all the links that I could find of the videos where you linked her are no longer there, so I don't know if she's doing anything separate anymore. If she is, please let her know that she is tagged on this. Music Chag, Punky Babe 2010, Mademoiselle Tianita, Unknown Pleasures Limited, Jasmine Amazing, Selena Manson, Fatima Tea Time, Princess Samira, Slime Bubbles, Brassy Bats, Napra Saria, Homicidal K, Imperial Fluffy Butt, Black Silk, Only on Two Wheels, Yasmin Benuit, Curvy Metalhead Show, Mystery Fabrizio, The Hot Coco, Young Medusa, Dolly Memorio, Miss Morgendorfer, Gabrielle K. Luna, Rain Alt Model, Truth and Positivity, Angelique Winter Papaya, Moriella Reborn, Damaris Everyday, R. Corpse Girl Saku, Hillary Hypnotic, Raijin Official, and some that I'm not quite sure if they have a actual YouTube page. If they do, awesome. But I don't know them from there, so I don't have that to tag them from. But I also want to tag in on here Dining with Dana, as well as Earl of Error Cosplay. Whew, that was a lot. But I wanted to include as many people as possible so the tag can grow and people can feel included in the community and they can pick their own bands. If I tagged you, it's because I got a feel that you are somebody that is goth and listens to gothic music. If I got some of that wrong, and according to the tag specifics, you don't know a band under any of those genres, I highly suggest that you check them out. Google a genre that sounds interesting to you. Go down the list of anything on, be it AllMusic or Spotify or Google or anything, and pick a band. And when you find them, do the video.
Thank you guys for tuning in. Hope some of you new people decide to check in with me by watching my videos or maybe subscribing if you like it. This is one of the few times I'm actually going to say the usual YouTube stuff, since I have a few new people probably checking me out from this tag. So, hope you guys have a good time, and I'll talk to you later. Bye, YouTube land.